All right, welcome back to the channel, everybody. Want to go over render cache. You can see this blue line on the timeline. It's because I have an optical between these two. And if I was to adjust it, you can see the line will turn red and it actually recaches this into memory. So if you go under playback, this is called render cache. And I have it on smart, which means whenever I'm not actively playing back and it's stopped, the system will go ahead and render these. And that way it can play back in real time more efficiently with the clip rendered to cache. Sometimes this can cause slow playback, so you could always turn it to none and you'll see the line will go away. The cache will quit updating until you turn that back on, or you can have it on user, which sends it to another location, which you can find underneath your preferences down here on the bottom right cogwheel. Under master settings, you have working folders down here, and there's this cache files location. You can designate that to an external drive, and it'll go a little bit faster if you needed to. Generally speaking, I keep it on smart, unless it's bogging me down and I'm not getting good playback. And keep in mind, you also have a Fusion memory cache that you can have on or off, essentially, or auto. So that'll cache that out in the background. Same thing when you're not running. Now you have delete render cache. You can go all. You can think of this as the project based. If you were in this project and you didn't want to kill off all your render cache, you could say all unused. It's smart enough to know which clips you've messed with and aren't actively in your timelines or project, or selected clips. So if you had a whole bunch of clips on your timeline and you actively selected the individual clips that you wanted cached, then you could go through and just grab whatever you were needing and say playback, delete selected clips, and it will clear out those. Or this is the part I wanted to show you guys, was manage render cache. So if you open that up, you essentially get your database. So right now we're under this current project. It's in our local database. Project libraries in the local database. And the project name for this one is Tutorial 4K. And it's telling us I have almost 65 gigs of cache. Now, if you have them in different spots, like on the cloud or a shared network, you can filter it by that, or project library. This works if you have multiple resolve systems. Most everyone will see it like this. And then you could filter it by location, or project library down here, or project name, or just the amount of render cache. So you can see we got a few different projects here taking up space, and they're all just cached files. If you clear them out and reload this project, it'll recache this nearly the same value or the same value. So if you get rid of it, think of it as it's gone until you reopen that project, and it'll have to crunch all this caching in the background to get real-time playback. If your system starts bogging down or you notice it's just sluggish, most of the time can help if you clear out some of your project's caching. So what you do is you check whichever ones you wanted to clear out and then hit clear selected cache. It does take a few moments. It'll go into your database and start clearing out the files, and then it'll give you a dialog box. It'll be done. And then you can close out, and sometimes that helps restore sluggish playback. But just something to be aware of if you were noticing you weren't getting like real-time playback. All right, as always, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.